Grr.
You please give a 10-second countdown.
10, right. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1, 0. Hello guys, welcome to Nuzlocke Season 4. This game is an FFA Wish Types Nuzlocke Pokemon Rangers. What a mouthful.
Oh, hi there. So this season we had everyone wish for their types, and everyone receive their types according to how they wish for it. The types that we have are Fire, Grass, Water, Normal, Flying, Fighting, Ice, Ghost, Psychic, Rock, Steel, Dragon, Bug, Ground, Electric, Poison, Fairy, and Dark type. So, the types go as follows. Fukano is the fire type. Water is Dragon Pasta. He's a watery one. Normal type, that's Pokey. Flying type is Floozemaker. Ice type goes to Bitexel. Ghost type goes to Majora. Psychic goes to ShutUpBrick. Rock goes to Dibscraft. Mr. Team Raven is the steel type. The dragon type is Happy 2016 from 4D underscore pixel. Ground type is Pencil Guy 37. The electric type is Harolin. The poison type is Chippy Toothy. The bug type is Kakintse. The fairy type is me. And dark type, green galaxy. And fighting type is Kelp.
And also grass type is Cappy.
I did, right? He's grass!
Okay, anyway. The Nuzlocke script has been modified and updated, but the game mode for this season is Pokemon Rangers, which is an added version of Bounty Hunters. Here are the adaptations. Every player starts without a bounty. The reward for killing someone without a bounty... The reward for killing someone with a bounty is experience points. If you kill someone without a bounty, your bounty increases or you obtain one by 15 experience points. Another effect of killing someone without a bounty is that the victim will not drop XP levels and the pursuer's XP levels will be halved. If you kill someone with a bounty, the victim will drop the reward according to the amount of kills they have gotten. Killing a person with a bounty won't result in a higher bounty for yourself. Obtain 30 XP levels, and you have the option to use those levels in enchanting or evolving. If you evolve, you receive half the amount of max hearts that you possess, since not all types gives the same amount of max hearts. Another attribution to evolution is that if you do evolve after you gain your max hearts, you are healed all the way back up to max health. Evolution can only be achieved once per type, and you can achieve evolution from XP received outside the game mode, meaning caving XP, mob XP, etc.
This is our first season in 1.8, but we're playing with decreased ores, bookshelves to prevent OP gear. Thanks to TommySX for the Teamspeak, thanks to HunterWolf for the server, thanks for DePenguin19, O16 Norge, and Kelt78 for both scripts. Meetup will be in 2 hours and 20 minutes with 20 minute long episodes. Map is 2k by 2k. No permadeath, no nether, no fire spread, no towering. Horses off, golden heads are off, vanilla apple rates and flint rates. Absorption off, and golden enderpearl damage is off.
Wait, when you said 2 hours and 20 minutes, you meant 2 hours, correct?
I don't know, this is the script.
Alright.
And I'm pretty sure the map's 18k by 18k.
Hours.
So.
No. 18,000 by
18,000! Yeah! Holy. Good game!
That's
one of those, so.
Okay, everybody unmute your mics and say, Global Crap!
What if I don't wanna?
You doing this again, Green? This is the second time you did this!
Everybody, you just got wrecked!
Prepare for trouble.
That was global. Anticlimactic. Global
craft and stuff.
Global craft.
Global craft.
Global craft.
What?
Oh no!
Oh,
no. We're setting walls.
My face when Tommy SX has not set the walls. Okay, welcome to Nuzlocke Season 4, Episode 1. Here we are, it's an FFA this time. And, yeah, Minecraft. What do you mean, wait, Vitexel? Did it start? Yes. Classic Vitexel. And here I am at basically the middle of one corner of the map. I swear to God. But yeah, so anyway, sorry about that. I am a whatchamacallit? Dark type. Yeah, oh my. My face one. Okay. But yeah, interesting enough, this is the second attempt of season 4 of Nuzlocke. The first attempt, Riker played, and he was this type. So, since he can't play now because his computer broke, which is actually the entire reason we are here with a second redo, is because Riker won originally the first season with 7 kills. I know, I'm sure it's shocking to everyone. That skeleton is right in front of the reeds that I would like to obtain. Oh, classical. There's multiple skeletons in front of the reeds that I would like to obtain. That's cool. But yeah, I'm dark type now, so basically I don't have to use torches, so that's pretty awesome. I'm still going to mine a bunch of coal and stuff, obviously, though, because I can get stuff like the, whatchamacallit. What am I trying to say here? Why am I so slow? Holy shit. I only have slowness 1, but it feels like I'm going super slow. Okay, but yeah, I'm dark type, so I guess I'll do this really quickly. Pokemon type dark. I have night vision. Arrow shots give blindness for 1 second. I do more melee damage at night in addition to having speed. And then during the day, or above light level 12, I will have slowness and weakness. So basically, the thing people can do to stop me from melee rushing them if it's nighttime is they can place lava, because then I'll have slowness and weakness. But I've realized that I am very, very good at melee with this, especially since, like... Okay, I'm going to describe my game plan. So me, Kak, and Brick were testing the script earlier today with, like, our types that we were going to have for the game. And I was dark type, so what I did was I gave myself sharp 4, and when it was night, I did 4.5 hearts to Brick per hit. So I'm definitely going to be caving this entire game until meetup, obtaining a sharp 4, and then potentially I'm going to go to the corner of the map, actually. That's what I'll do. I'm strategizing this so that I can make my perfect plan for getting to meet up at time when it's dark out instead of it being light out, because then I can abuse the fact that I'll have strength and... Yeah, okay, there you go. He was just testing. But yeah, I'm going to try and abuse the fact that I can get strength and speed at night, and actually what Riker told me to do, because I told him that I have his type now in Nuzlocke, what he told me to do was cave during the times of the episodes when it's day, and don't cave when it's night. So I'm gonna probably do that after I'm basically set up and everything, like with enchants and all that. And hopefully it will work out pretty well for me. I'm trying to get as many of the feathers here that I possibly can. However, I have not seen any form of leather yet, so I would really like to find some of that, because that would be very important to my game strategy, obviously. Also, I need regular food, because I have raw chicken, and I'm unable to eat it. Okay, there we go. Why is this happening? Okay. That was weird. Anyway, yeah, so I'm going to be probably abusing a majority of the potion effects that I have. It's really nice that I have night vision, too, because that means that I don't have to use torches in my cave, which means that whenever I'm in a cave, I'm going to do a lot of damage to mobs in general, so that's really good. I believe the reason why my thing keeps toggling is because of the fact that I'm running under trees. Maybe that might be a potential trigger of the slowness and speed effects, and that's why I'm obtaining them very strangely. That would actually be probably my most likely guess as to what's happening here. But, yeah, let's see if I can try and find, cows or something in this plains over here. I'm probably gonna go back to the swamp and cave here, too, because I don't know if this is an actual, like, proven fact or anything, but I swear every time I dig down in the swamp, I always find a mine shaft. So I'm gonna do my best to try and do that, even though I most likely won't be getting a bow more powerful than, like, power 3 or power 2, even. Because, obviously, I'm going to be trying my best to get sharpness 4 iron, so... Actually, if I can find enough leather, I'm going to... Oh, this pack has outline doors, so I'm going to change packs. But yeah, if I can, I'm going to try and make as many books as possible and potentially make a diamond sword instead, because that would be very, very helpful to my caving process. Well, not my caving process, my PvP process, especially at nighttime when... Because if I have a sharpness 3 diamond, I'm going to be doing, like, my sword damage is a lot higher at night. I don't have strength because fighting is the only type that's allowed to have strength. But, yeah, I'm going to definitely be making at least a sharp 3 sword this game. If I don't do that, then I don't know what I would have to do. But basically, I'm going to prioritize everything in my inventory about melee. I'm not going to try anything at all to get, like, a better bow or anything like that, because honestly, it's not too big of a priority to me to have a good bow over a good sword in this game, especially because of the fact that my things have that. Obviously, I'm still going to try my best and get as many arrows as I possibly can, for example, which is why I'm not going to grab too many more feathers than what I have right now, because 30 is very good, so I don't think I need that many things. However, what I am going to do is, since I've grabbed all this iron already, this was not part of my plan, but this, since I've already grabbed all this iron, I'm going to stay up all night. Okay, my face when Raven pays attention. But yeah, I'm going to stay up at night now and get spiders super early on, so that way I can get a bow as quickly as possible. And, yeah, we're going to try and get everything situated potentially by episode 3, is what I would like, because basically, I'm going to be just caving a very large portion of the time in the game for, mainly XP, I would think, maybe? I don't know. I just really want to find leather right now, please. I just want leather. Leather-dropping animals, where art thou? Okay, this cow's. After I kill these cows, I'm going to go back to the swamp and cut down some trees there. And in addition to that, cook all my iron and everything. Alright, I have at least one piece of leather, so it seems as if I am alright to go, at least with enchants. At least the basic ones, that is. So yeah, I'll probably most likely be trying to get sharp 4 iron instead of sharpness 3 diamond, because I don't believe I'm going to obtain too much more leather than I currently have, unfortunately enough, but that's alright. I mean, I'm going to keep all the sugarcane I have on me at all times, so in the potential possibility that I could get a diamond sword, I will do it, but it's not on my highest priority list of everything I have to do. But yeah, the second I get back to the swamp here in a minute, I'm gonna change packs because I'm not a fan of the outline doors in this pack. In case anybody's curious as to what this pack is, though, it's Scopehead's pack. Scopehead's simplistic pack, I think is what it's called. I can actually confirm that when I go to change packs in a second. My sounds are at 30, okay. I want to make sure that they're at a decent level because I don't want them overpowering my voice, because that's usually, I personally don't like that in videos when the game sounds or anything else like Teamspeak sounds override the volume of the person's voice. But yeah. Anyway, I don't know when this will be released, but the first attempt was played after Ambition Season 12. And I won't say anything about that just in case it hasn't been released by now. But during the later episodes, I may talk more about it, because it's more likely to have been released by a later time. I'm gonna just kill all these chickens just so nobody else can have them. I'm not really prioritizing having too many arrows, because I don't plan on using a bow, at least during the nighttime period. However, I might use it just in case, because I tried melee rushing Brick a lot, and sometimes it worked, and sometimes it didn't, so I don't know. But I'm definitely going to be abusing the hell out of my night vision and not lighting up my cave, and also hopefully being able to see people before they see me, because if I can do that, that would be amazing. However, there's a very, very good possibility that Majora, for example, could sneak up on me in my cave, because he is ghost type, So basically, whenever he is below a certain Y level, he will he's gonna receive, what is it? He gets invis too, I think, and he's been removed from a team as well. So he's not gonna have, like, there's gonna be no potential way to see that he's there. I forgot to grab coal in that cave. Damn it. Okay. That's fine, I guess. I'll do that. And should be good to go. I'm gonna just continue chopping down trees here really quickly. It's funny, actually. Majority of my oh no! God damn it, Majora! Dang it! He always dies so early in FFA recorded rounds. It sucks so much. Oh yeah, Kelt said that in chat too. So in the first attempt, Kelt killed Majora while he was in his cave, and that was a bit of a silly move, especially since it was only episode 2, but whatever. Yes, 40. My face when an organizer doesn't know what episode their recorded round is currently on. But yeah, I have night vision, so watching my perspective is going to be super easy to do if you are usually not a fan of my perspective because of how dark it is usually, because I don't use torches very often in games. So it's understandable that you wouldn't want to watch me, especially if I was not giving a good old brightness level. I'm gonna go find that fucking cave that I dug down in. Well, not dug down in, but grabbed iron from, and go grab more coal. That's... Who's that? That's 40. Okay, that's why he asked if it was first episode, I would assume. It's because he saw me. I don't know why he would want to fight me anyway, but still. Oh, I hear a spider already. That's good. Where's the spider at? Oh, what? It's invis! God damn it. Jesus Christ, that scared me. Okay. Jesus, that really just gave me a heart attack. Okay, come here, spider. Chippy is here, too. I just saw 40 run that direction. What the hell? But, yeah, I definitely want to get away from Chippy. Chippy is one of the better people in this round right now, so I really, really don't want to be near him. Engel was not capable of playing. I don't know why, but Riker just can't play because his computer is broken, as I may have previously mentioned. If I have not, that's the whole entire reason, basically, behind why we're redoing. So yeah. Anyway, Chippy is the only person in the game with above 10 hearts, normally, because he is poison type, so that's gonna be interesting. I think the best way for me to kill Chippy is definitely melee. Because whenever you hit him regardless, you have a 20% chance, I think it is, of being poisoned. So it'd be good, it'd be better to kill him quicker through melee than it would be to kill him through a bow fight, because that would obviously not last, that would last very long, actually, and that would take more of a toll on my health than it would if I were to melee rush him. But, yeah, how much wood do I have currently? I have 33, so about half a stack of logs. I'm gonna get more than that, though, because it's very good to have a large amount of wood in your inventory. If you kill me later this game, I'm never touching UHC again. Oh no. That's not good. I guess I'll make more sticks, yeah. Okay. But I definitely want to get into a cave very quickly, like very soon, so hopefully this can hurry up and go a lot quicker than it currently is. I'm just gonna make all this armor right now. God, that fucking spider scared me. I can make an iron sword actually just regularly, like on my own, so I'm gonna do that now, just so that I can kill mobs quicker. Three hit that zombie. I don't think it affects mobs, but it definitely affects players. It certainly does affect players more, I know that much, because obviously we were testing it, so. Yeah, but I really don't want to kill anybody super early on. Like, that's not what my plan is. Definitely not at all is to kill anyone early on. God, I've killed 3 spiders and I only have 2 string. Oh yeah, Engel originally had steel type, actually, and that was ridiculous, because if Engel was steel type, I'll show you guys in a minute what steel type has. It would be incredibly ridiculous if Engel had that. Basically, I can tell you one thing that it has, and that's possibility to have single, double, or no ores, and I'm pretty sure the double ores was like a 25% chance or something, and then no ores is like 5% or something, so I don't know. It's just ridiculous, because if Engel had that, that would be terrible for, like, everyone, because Engel's very good at caving, and he would probably obtain, like, 30 apples or something extremely ridiculous. So, yeah. Anyway, one of the people I'm definitely going to be steering clear of this game is Brick, especially because he's doing very well at PvE right now. He hasn't taken damage yet. Brick with a power 4 does like 4.5 hearts to people in half proj, so it's going to be very, very difficult to fight him with a bow. If anything, I definitely have to like wait for somebody else to fight him first, because I cannot be the first person to fight Brick. It would literally not be possible. I would end up just failing overall completely. And that would not be good for anyone, really. So, yeah. I guess another thing about Nuzlocke that lowers the incentive of killing people early on is the fact that heads are off. So I guess that's sort of good, because it would deter people from fighting others super early. Especially since I'm about to dig down here. Yeah, I'm gonna dig down, like, right here. I have to remember that I'm Dark-type this time, because in the first attempt, I was Ground-type, which I believe Pencil has now. And Ground-type's actually pretty good, but I evaluated Ground-type versus Dark-type, and I definitely thought that Dark-type was gonna do a lot better in the actual game, so I decided to pick Dark-type over Ground. The reason behind that, why that was possible, is because, Kak has it so whenever a person who can't play or a sub is playing, official members who are, like, planned to play have the option of switching their type with a sub. So basically what I did was, since Riker can't play anymore, I stole his dark type, and other people received, in this case, it would be Pencil. Pencil received my ground type. I completely forgot to change packs. I'm going to do that right now. So yeah, that was scopes, and we're gonna switch to bushies with no highlighted ores. Okay. But yeah, here we are doing the good old Minecraft. Hope you guys are enjoying my perspective somewhat so far. I don't know why my thing is taking so long to change packs. Hopefully my game doesn't crash. If it does, that would be very unfortunate. I believe it's going to. Actually, it's not good. Okay, no, it didn't. Okay, nice. But yeah, now it's gonna feel sorta slow for me. I don't know if it's gonna slow down the actual perspective. But, yeah. I need to really stop saying that. My perspective in, like, a lot of recorded rounds mainly consists of but, yeah, and oh. Nice. Bye, Texel. I'm just really afraid of how this game's gonna turn out, because, I mean, I did win the official test game of Nuzlocke, like, when we were still changing the values of everything and all that, but I was flying type in that game, which is, like, honestly one of the worst types, so I don't know how I won, but I got 6 kills in the test game, and in the first attempt, I did terribly because I was fighting Kelt. I know exactly what I need to do from Kelt, and that's stay away from him, like, by, like, 40 blocks at all times. I'm not going anywhere near Kelt ever in my entire life. That's not happening. I don't know where this water is. It really feels like it's right below me. It is, okay. And, yeah, so I'm basically just gonna be trying my best to stay away from Kelt, because Kelt fucking destroyed me last time with his strength. I was ground, so I had slowness, and then I got Kelt below a certain health level, so he gained speed. And that was just a very, very bad time for me, because obviously I have slowness. Well, I did have slowness, like, all around when I was ground type, so that was not very fun. Down here, since it's by lava, I'm gonna have slowness as well, slowness and weakness, but there's nothing you can really do about that. I'm gonna just ask if roller coastering is on, because I'm most likely gonna be doing that this game over anything else, because of the fact that I seemingly don't have a cave right now. I'm gonna make a few furnaces actually and cook up this food, just so that I don't, like, starve to death. But yeah, let's do that, and in addition, do this. But yeah, there's people I wanna avoid this game at all costs: Cappy, Raven, Chippy, Brick, Dragon, Kelt. Basically, like, half the entire game. So I'm just really scared overall, basically, of what could possibly happen in this game. Especially because, like, it's so unpredictable. It's literally ridiculous how unpredictable Nuzlocke is. I'm gonna actually ask here, literally in 1 second, about roller coastering and whatnot. I believe it was allowed in the first attempt, but I'm just gonna double check and make sure that it's still allowed. Because you obviously don't want to break the rules of the round, so. And, there's the end of episode 1. I will see you guys next time.